On the first day walking in, they told us to meet in the main lobby of the hospital. And I was like, okay, hopefully I can find that. And it was unmistakable. You walk in the big front doors and the receptionist is greeting you. And you're like, oh, I'm here for my first day. And to them, it's just any other Monday. But it was, you're sitting in the main lobby and it's just such an awesome feeling and sense of you're in this wonderful place to learn.
Our NPPA fellowships here at Mayo are an incredible opportunity for NPPAs that are looking for postgraduate education. We offer something very unique here that you really can't get anywhere else in the country or even the world, potentially. All of our fellowships here are in very unique and specialized fields of medicine that NPPAs may not have even had a lot of exposure to during school. Things like cardiology and advanced heart failure, hematology, oncology, critical care, neurosurgery, ENT, abdominal transplant, even things like palliative care. They're very unique and specialized fields that I think if NPPAs have an interest in, this is an amazing place to learn about and to really become amazing providers themselves at the conclusion of their training.
Mayo Clinic in Arizona is at the precipice of growth here in the Phoenix Valley. And we are creating and developing relationships with powerhouses throughout the valley and throughout the state. And I truly feel that our location here at Mayo Clinic in Arizona is sort of the center point of the future of health sciences in the state of Arizona. So how does this relate to the NPPA fellowships? It's a growing career field, and the fellowship programs are just a continued way to advance your training and advance your practice. And with the resources, with the Arizona Bold Forward project, will be paramount.
Mayo actually has one of the more diverse campuses that I've seen. In Sacramento, I worked in the hospital there. We did have a diverse campus there as well, but I feel like Mayo really reaches out to other cultures, people of color, people of different religions, and really tries to bring them in to the Mayo campus so that you can really get that diverse workforce, because your patients are diverse. You're not necessarily going to have like all of one certain patient. Everybody is different, and so it's really great to have a hospital that recognizes that and help provide those patients with a more comfortable environment, because they are reaching out to more diverse staff and faculty than just one certain culture.
I've just really fallen in love with the Phoenix area. There's so many opportunities here, as well as just professional and personal opportunities. There are such amazing healthcare no matter where you look. If you want to be in downtown Phoenix or if you want to be kind of on the outskirts, you've got just different healthcare opportunities everywhere that you look, as well as just all these opportunities to explore new places, going up to Sedona, up to Flagstaff, going down to Tucson. Everything is really accessible, and whether it's a couple hours by car or a quick flight for a weekend getaway, it's a great place to be.
Arizona has a lot of fun things to offer as far as recreational activities to do. Again, even though it's very hot here in the summer, hopefully you quickly acclimate to that, as many of us have, and can enjoy the beautiful winters that we have here as well. A lot of outdoor activities is kind of the primary recreational activity that I think me and my family do, and a lot of I know our fellows and other staff do. So things like hiking and swimming and lots of outdoor activities as much as possible, getting to enjoy the beautiful desert that we have here.
Whether it's going for a run or a bike ride after work, it gives me the perfect opportunity to reset and show up to work the next day or the next night with a fresh mind. Another thing that I love about Phoenix is the blossoming food and art scene downtown. You're close to all sorts of areas like downtown Phoenix, also the cities of Scottsdale and the cities of Chandler. And Mesa and Gilbert are all growing, and there's no lack of opportunity to get out and explore and involve yourself within your local community. So my favorite restaurant and my favorite kind of food scene actually is not in downtown Phoenix. It's actually up in Cave Creek, which is a little bit closer to where I grew up, but it's just a totally different environment than you would expect in downtown Phoenix. and it sort of gives you an opportunity to explore the local history of Arizona in the olden days, and it has a little bit more of a Western vibe, which is fun.
This is a very exciting time for Mayo Clinic in Arizona. Over the next few years, we're expecting an exponential growth in both the hospital and the clinic. And I think that makes it a really fun time for our NPPA fellows as well, because what that means is a lot of new job opportunities for them. I think that with new opportunities, we will hopefully be able to get each and every one of our fellows kind of the perfect job that they've always dreamed of, because we will have that many more opportunities.
My biggest piece of advice to any incoming NPPA fellow is to remember that what you gain and get out of your fellowship is directly reflective of what you put in. So remembering that this is a choice and a commitment to the opportunity of a lifetime to allow yourself to become one of the best APPs in your field and to better yourself, not only as a clinical provider, but also as a person.